Hi, Gemini. It's Kelly Lunt bringing you your mid-month March 2017 tune-up for what you need to know the rest of this month to manifest what you want with ease, joy, bliss, and all the good feels. So it looks like at the beginning of the month, you were being guided by spirit to let you know that it's time to start taking yourself more seriously. And as a byproduct of that, you're going to have a deepening relationship with others. So let's see what they want you to know as a tune-up to that message. Nice. A lot of earth cards. So you're definitely continuing on the path of connection with others. Ooh, and a lot of air cards. Okay. Guys, this is a pretty good spread. okay, so Geminis, for the base, you've got the Queen of Earth, Knight of Earth, and the Ten of Earth. Okay. Now, so Earth, it's very family-oriented, it's very connecting, it's very grounding, connecting to yourself, connecting with others. Queen of Earth and Ten of Earth are like the base. So it's definitely time to make time for like those around you. Continue spending time with people. You know, it's just like a practice. You're practicing how to build deeper relationships with others. So you got to practice, you know, it's a new skill set. But so the Queen of Earth is probably the most like loving and nurturing and understanding of the four queens. It's definitely the most, I mean, it's Earth. It's the most nurturing. So whatever it is you're supposed to do, it's definitely being guided to be very nurturing with those around you as you develop the relationship. So for example, if you're a little older, or even if you're just ahead of them on the maturity scale, like emotional development and like conflict resolution development, it's, you know, approach it very nurturing. You know, no one means to hurt you. No one's evil. They're just simply doing the best that they know how at that time. So nurture them. Yeah, but they're letting you know that the base is like, you know, for the rest of this month, it's 10 of Earth, just a very happy family life, financial security, finding magic in the little things in life. And like, just look at the image. It's definitely about spending time with others this month. It's definitely about nurturing those relationships. Because you know, whenever you make a new friendship, you want to put forth that extra foot forward to make sure to build that relationship. You know, relationships in the beginning take a little more effort than they do when you're in like maintenance mode. So it's definitely, and since you do have the Knight of Earth as like crossing the Queen of Earth as the challenge of the month, it's like kind of get stuff done. Take the initiative. Like be the first one to do the invite. Be the first one to text. Be the first, you know, like put forth that effort to continue the deepening relationships. And for others, for yourself as well. It's really time to like take this, you know, like anytime you have a practice, you know, like when you first start meditation, the first step that most people will tell you is develop a practice. Just pick 10 minutes every day where you're going to sit and make time and space for that. So it's the same thing here. Knight of Earth crossing the Queen of Earth. It's, you know, take the 15 minutes every day to connect with your lover, to connect with yourself. And that 15 minutes can be quiet meditation. Or it could be, you know, journal. You know, journal. Take the 15 minutes just to tune in with yourself and the 15 minutes with the others. Because it's a practice. But so this is interesting. In the recent past, you got the Sun. So that's obviously, you know, you've had a pretty mellow good month. You've had a good month so far. Things are going well for you. That's a good card to get there. But right now you've got the Moon card in the right now. So it's definitely, the Moon is kind of that, you know, like psychic kind of connection, psychic development. It's all about trusting your internal guidance system. It's like there's confusion right now. So maybe it's their actions and their words aren't lining up. So it's all about like trusting your spiritual insights into the situation, your gut, your intuition, clairvoyant, clairsentient, whatever you call it. Trust your gut. Trust your emotional read of the situation. That's what's going to help you the most. You know, it's either because if someone's like, no, I don't want to hang out with you verbally, but everything else they're doing indicates they want to hang out with you, be the first one to take the step, to patch things up, to make the first initiation to hang out. You know, because it is kind of hard sometimes to say you like someone and you want to hang out, you know? Or it could be that they're saying they want to hang out and they don't. In which case, trust your gut. Your internal guidance system doesn't lead you astray. Trust it, you know? Yeah, because it definitely looks like... So, they're guiding you... Okay, this is interesting now that I see the whole spread. They're guiding you to be very nurturing this month with the Queen of Earth and the Knight of Earth be the first one to take the step to be nurturing. Because it definitely looks like... You have a little bit of potential conflict coming up with someone else. It's either conflict with someone else or it's like conflict within yourself. So, you know, like when you're healing, how do I say this to you guys? Like, you know, if you're in a relationship with someone else and you're triggered and they're triggered, that's generally not a good time in the relationship because they're triggered, you're triggered, everyone's just trying to self-protect themselves, okay? So it's definitely like take the time to heal from it, recognize that they definitely didn't mean it. It's definitely the other person, however they're communicating with you. You got the Page of Air. The Air suit is very logical, very rational, your brain, and Page is a very immature type. So if there's conflict with someone else, whatever they said was not delivered with any kind of tact. It was just, it's the equivalent of someone saying, you're rude. Instead of saying, hey, you know, yesterday when you said X, Y, Z, I perceived it this way. Is that how you meant it? That's a little bit more, the second way is a little bit more inviting for a conversation, a little more, let's build this relationship. The first way is just, you're rude, F you, and you storm out, you know? So some sort of information is delivered abruptly, without tact, in a way that, you know, doesn't make you emotionally feel good. Or if it's with yourself, it means you're being too hard on yourself. You know, the whole, well, I only have 400 YouTube subscribers now, I must not be good enough. It's no, nurture that relationship with yourself and nurture and say, hey, you're at 400 right now. You'll soon be at 10,000. This is just a stepping stone to get there, you know? Like, just be okay with your journey. Yeah, so this is interesting for you to get the 10 of Air, which is definitely a sad card, but the sun is in your immediate past. The 10 of Air is your personal power this month. Okay, guides, what do they need to know about this? Oh, it's that overall, you're, you know, the whole cocoon to a butterfly thing. That's my favorite, one of my favorite analogies, I should say. You're definitely, because you're growing to a new phase of your life, and you recently saw some success from it. So like if you took a conflict resolution class or a anger management class, or you did something to better your internal communication with others, your emotional growth, you saw some success with it because you're overall just at a new phase of emotional maturity. And so it's like you're kind of coming out of the hardship of that phase and starting to step into the fun part of it, you know, where you kind of, you know, whenever you learn a new skill, you kind of have to face some of your old traumas or face some old ways that you may have treated people, and you have to forgive the other person, you have to forgive yourself. It's like you're coming out of that type of a phase. And so, you know, when you're going through it, it's like, oh my God, I'm a horrible person. I can't believe I said that. What was I thinking? I just didn't know any better. Or, you know, when you're reliving a trauma that someone else did to you, that's not fun. But you're starting to come out of it. So that part's fun because you enjoy life more. You're like, oh, my friends are awesome. Yeah. And then it's just be aware that other people this month, they're the Page of Air. So it just means they're a little bit, perhaps not quite as mature as you. So, you know, just be the bigger person this month and love them, be nurturing. Just recognize that they don't mean to hurt you. Yeah, because you're definitely starting to acknowledge your growth and you're starting to acknowledge. It's almost as if You're learning how to like love the haters. Okay? Let that sink in. You're like learning how to love the haters. You're learning how to interact with people who don't necessarily communicate the same way you do. Like, you know how some people are very sensory? They're like the scientists. They're, I need to measure everything perfectly. And then there's people on the opposite spectrum, like me, we're very intuitive. So it's almost as if you're starting to recognize that you're able to communicate with more types of people outside of the way that you communicate. And the Empress, so you got the Empress and the Queen of Earth, guys. Like, they're both two of the most nurturing cards in this deck. The Major Arcana and one of the Minor Arcana. And this is a royal card, too. So you definitely, it's definitely a month of nurturing yourself and nurturing yourself. And it, but it's like nurturing yourself and nurturing the relationship with yourself. So I hope that makes sense, guys. It's not just about taking the bubble baths, taking the hikes, playing with your gemstones. It's, you know, it's not about just the self-care. It's about deepen the relationship with yourself. It's, you know, that's journaling, that's tapping into your emotions, that's waking up every morning and taking three deep breaths and then asking yourself, how do I feel? It's really tuning into yourself and your emotional guidance system, or like Abraham Hicks' Law of Attraction, tend to your vortex, tend to your emotions, and get to know yourself a little bit more. But yeah, it looks like the second half of the month is going to pick up for you a bit. So it's likely going to be because you're starting to come out of the difficult phase of growth and stepping into the fun part of it. So things are going to, you know, that's when you're in your synchronistic flow and things start to happen better for you. Or not better, but like easier, quicker. You start seeing rewards for your hard work and that kind of stuff. So meaning people will start responding to it. Like, let's just say you used to be an alcoholic. You were not, just being blunt, like you probably weren't that fun to be around if the other people were sober, okay? It's like you came out of the alcoholic phase. You are in the recovery mode. You're in the recovery mode of it. And it's time to like keep nurturing that relationship with yourself and keep nurturing those relationships with others. And they're going to start seeing that you're a different person now. And you're going to start seeing their different person now. So people are going to start like trusting you more. That was just one example, guys. Okay. So apply it to your situation. It's just things are going to start picking up now. You've put in a lot of the work. You've done a lot of the internal work. You're definitely being guided to continue nurturing that relationship with yourself and with others. And it's really definitely just, you got the moon. So it's definitely tuning into yourself more and trusting your internal guidance system this month. That's what I was first. So for the mid-month tune-up, it's definitely continue nurturing the relationship with yourself, continue nurturing with others, and really start to begin to trust yourself and internal guidance system. Because I got to tell you guys, like, I know that when I was first building my intuition and my connection with my guides, sometimes they would just tell me, no, don't hang out with that person. And I just, why not? They look really nice. They're offering me coffee. I want to chat with them. And, you know, sure enough, like 10 minutes, 30 minutes, 2 hours later, it was not working out at all. It was horrible. Like, and I was just like, oh my God, get me out of here. So because I had enough of those experiences where my internal gut, my guidance system, the feeling in my chest was telling me either yes or no around certain people. Once I was told no, and I would do it anyway, I realized, trust your nose. That's like the lesson you're going through right now, is if, you know, trust your nose and trust your yeses. Yeah, you gotta trust your yeses too, because there was another example. My guides wanted me to plan an ecstatic dance here in Chattanooga, Tennessee, and I did not want to. I'm a nerd. I'm that girl who plays StarCraft. I have freaking Barbies right behind me. I'm a full-out nerd, and I don't like party, you know? And I just thought, you guys are crazy. Why would you want me to do that? But they kept saying yes. And I just, you know, because I built that relationship with my guides. I built that relationship with myself that I've learned that every time I follow my yeses, things just work out. And sure enough, I've met so many people in town now who are really good friends and a really good support system now. And I'm even helping them launch their businesses. So it's giving me, like, it's me helping them. That's a benefit to them. And I get friendship and I get a boost of confidence that, you know, so I'm doing something right. And it just worked out. So many people were healed from it and it really boosted my confidence. So like, trust your yeses and trust your noes, like trust yourself, you guys. Okay. My Gemini, go ahead and like comment below. You can join me for my Facebook Lives every Monday, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. If you want a personalized channel message for you from Spirit, join. It's I'll link to my Facebook page down below in YouTube. If you guys have any questions, though, comments, shoot me an email, kelly@kellylunt.com. I am offering a new service now where it's a monthly package now. So if you book a session with me, it is $5.97 now. Just go to my website, kellylunt.com, and hit, you got to fill out an application because I want to, you know, I read your application and I meditate on it with my guides to make sure that you're someone who we could best help. I really help people who are looking to achieve something that they never, that right now they can't dream it's possible. That's who I help best. I help, you know, I'm working with a girl right now who she's in Kentucky and she wants to get out to Oregon. After 3 sessions, she's already given notice to her job. And, you know, I have HR manager experience too. I was that for 5 years when I did the corporate world gig. You know, we're working on her resume and we're getting her out there. She's already has 2 interviews lined up. She's already given notice to her current job. Like that's the type of people that I want to work with. If there's growth or transformation in your life that you want, fill out the application. It'll be my 5 guides and me on the phone with you for 90 minutes, $5.97. And then you also get a full month of support from that. You can email me. You can send me a text. You can send me a voice clip. That's the latest offering that I have out there if you'd like it. And from that, like, much love, Gemini. It looks like it's all about building that trust with yourself. And, you know, once you do that, life gets so much easier, so much better, so much, God, just synchronistic. So keep going on. Mwah. Love you guys.